quite the moves in the market ahead of this. I mean, 6.5% rally for a stock this large, for a company with this market cap, is phenomenal. People getting overexcited?
Yeah, the moves today and frankly over the course of this year, it certainly highlights that investor expectations for the next generation of iPhone products are certainly high. iPhones still account for the majority of Apple's revenue. And the feature set in this particular cycle appears to be pretty packed. You know, you mentioned 5G technology. They also will release a broader variety of screen sizes, the broadest variety, in fact, in the history of the product, in addition to a slew of other features that I think we think has investor expectations relatively high.
Relatively high, and interesting, of course, that to a certain extent, the infrastructure in America isn't quite ready to support it. We know that Verizon has done a lot of investing, and 5G is fast and furious, but only in limited parts of certain cities, and perhaps to a lesser extent at some of the other telecom providers. How much will a 5G phone really make much difference when you have one in your hand?
Certainly a good question there. I think what's changed in the last couple of years, if we think back to the last time that Apple materially changed the speed that the phone could achieve, people were buying cell phones, buying iPhones every 2 years. Now the average buyer of an iPhone holds it for a longer period of time. So we think that a lot of consumers will be interested in, quote-unquote, future-proofing their products here, buying 5G, even if in their specific geographical market, 5G isn't necessarily pervasive, because if they plan to hold on their phone for 3 or 4 years, this is some technology that they're going to want to take advantage of going forward.
And, of course, the infrastructure is there in China. How much is that going to be a focus for how sales continue?
Yeah, China certainly is a large and meaningful market for Apple. It continues to have a luxury presence, a luxury perception if you do have an iPhone in China. China's significant, especially as 5G is very pervasive there, and we expect them to do well in China going forward.
Of course, we have earnings coming a little bit later. What sort of data do you think that you'll actually be able to pass from Apple when they have delayed, of course, the unveiling of their most important feature and product of the year?
This is going to be a really interesting quarter for Apple for several reasons. Number one, the iPhone has never been delayed this much into the quarter in the history of the product. And typically, if we had been talking, probably call it a month ago, if they had released on time, Apple would typically have about 5 to 6 weeks of real sales data about these new iPhones, from which to maybe forecast what the December quarter might look like in terms of their financials. Apple, a couple weeks from now when they actually report earnings, Apple will have considerably less data, perhaps only a week of new iPhone data from which to forecast. So it's certainly going to be a different quarter for Apple. In the last couple quarters, they haven't actually guided. So we'll see what happens as we approach earnings.